When removing the axle, you will need to loosen the 32mm 12-point nut on the axle, as indicated by the yellow arrow. If you do not have an impact gun, the best way to do this is pop off the center cap on the wheel, and with the wheel on and the vehicle on the ground, use a very large breaker bar. You want to loosen the nut before raising the vehicle. You're going to have to disconnect some of the suspension components from the wheel carrier, and while you do not need to remove the brake caliper, pads, and rotor, red arrow, I like to. This gives you much easier access to the control struts when you can move the dust shield around. The axle collar nut will have a section of it that is folded into the gap in the axle. Use a punch and tap the metal out, as indicated by the red arrow. This will allow you to remove the 32mm 12-point collar nut. There are no nuts and bolts holding the inner CV joint to the differential. The axle shaft sits in a flange inside the differential and is held in place by a retaining ring. If there is oil dripping from the seal between the axle and the differential, you will need to replace the seal. While you do not need to remove the brake system, you do need to remove the sensors from the brakes. I like to take the brakes off and hang the caliper out of the way, red arrow. With everything off, you can remove the two 5mm Allen bolts and the two 13mm bolts holding the dust shield in place. The ability to turn the dust shield makes removing the suspension struts much easier, and removing the brakes also reduces the weight of the hub when it comes time to muscle it around. With the dust shield free to move, you can spin it around and remove the camber strut, red arrow, the torque strut, yellow arrow, the tie rod, blue arrow, and the control arm, not showing, where they connect to the wheel carrier. Lower the jack and pull the wheel carrier forward. If your axle is stuck in the bearing in the wheel carrier, you can use a three-arm puller, red arrow, to gently walk the axle out of the carrier. Otherwise, the wheel carrier should be pulled outward and down, freeing the axle from the carrier. This photo illustrates the struts disconnected from the wheel carrier and the carrier pulled forward and off the axle. Next, simply pull the axle straight out from the differential. You may need to give it a couple of good tugs, but it will come straight out. Just be careful, it is heavy. Inspect the flange at the end of the axle, and if you are reinserting the same axle, make sure to replace the retaining clip that sits in a small groove in the differential end, yellow arrow. If the differential has been leaking, replace the seal by prying out the old one and installing a new one. Make sure to check the level of the oil in the differential. Installation is the reverse of removal. Thanks for watching. Click here to view the original article, along with hundreds of other DIY content for your car.